Welcome to my next tutorial on DaVinci Resolve. On this one, we're going to be working on color correction, doing a primary color grade on all of our clips. To get onto the color page, we're going to click down the bottom on color, and we get a window like this. Yours might be slightly different. There might be keyframes showing down the bottom right. We want to make sure that scopes is showing down here on the right, and make sure it's on parade like this. Just to go through everything, up here we've got a stills gallery. We'll get to that in a little bit. We can hide that for now just by clicking on gallery. We've got our viewer at the top. Up here is our node screen, which is similar to Photoshop layers, but it's like a sequence of nodes. Down the bottom we've got our scopes, which is very important, and then we've got our color wheels and our color adjustments at the bottom. Yours might look a little bit different. You can either use the primary wheels or the primary bars. I like to use the primary bars myself. So let's get started. The first two clips are actually quite nicely lit already. The colors are quite nice. You can have a look. We've got a fairly even balance between our red, greens and blues. But if you actually look on the scopes, the reds at the bottom, which is like the blacks, the greens and blues are slightly not balanced. So we can adjust that using the offset over here. This is how we can sort of fix our white balance. So we can bring down our greens so that they match our reds. We can then bring down our blues so they match our reds. And this will just do a generally fix. All I'm actually looking is at the scopes at the bottom, trying to make these lines all match up. So looking at that, and then you can actually have a look at your viewer and see what you've done. You can always do Control D, which will turn off this node. So you can see we've already gone from slightly washed out to the blacks are all looking a little bit blacker. We can then now start our adjustments using these main sliders over here. So to adjust the blacks, we could bring all of these down a little bit so it's closer to zero, which is then gonna make the blacks more black. So just rolling this one back, looking at the scopes till it's about touching. Yeah, they're all a bit touching. You can see the blue's still a little bit off, so we could actually maybe roll the blue down a little bit more. And now you can see, yet again, Control D. See, this was all a bit blue and washed out. It's already looking a little bit punchy and nice. Now, if you look at the top of our scopes, these are our highlights. You can see there's not very balanced. Red's a little bit overpowering than green and the blue. We can bring our reds down on our highlights. Lift is lows, gamma is mids, gain is highlights. So we can bring these reds down to try and match these a little bit. And maybe the greens down a little bit. Try and match these all up. And now everything's looking very naturally colored. You can then control the whole of the gains and not well looking. You want to keep this under 1023, sort of closer towards the 896. I think about there looks nice. Once you're happy with this, this is our primary grade finished. We can right click and go grab still. This has basically taken all of our settings and now put them in our gallery. So this one up here is all of our settings from the last clip. We can then go to our next clip, we can right click on our still and then left click on apply grade, and it will put all of those settings onto here. It hasn't actually worked too well on this one. You can see the highlights are a little bit wrong and the blacks have been pushed a bit too far down. So what we can do is bring our lift back up until we're about, the reds are on the bottom. You see the greens and the blues now are actually slightly off. So let's use our offset again, bring our greens up to match, bring our blues up to match. Okay, so they're all matching. Look at our highlights. Highlights, maybe the blues are a little bit brighter here. Look at these spikes here. Maybe bring the blue down a little bit on our gain, on our highlights. Blue down a little bit. And I think there we go. If we press Control D again, it's gone from that, and it's really sort of pushed the blacks down and made everything pop up. There are two other settings you can do. I haven't actually played with the gammas yet. The gamma brings up the mid-range. So you just use the mid-range wheel here to where you like it. I think it's about fine there. We'll also do it on this one. We can see what the gamma wheel does. It'll bring up the sort of the mids. I think it's kind of nice where it is. One other thing you can do just to boost the colors to make things look a little, give it a little bit more punch, is increase the saturation. You don't want to go crazy with this. See, if we go up to 100, now it looks very cartoony, it looks unnatural. Maybe push this up to like 60 or 60 to 70. I think even that's a little bit too much. Let's bring it down to 65. Okay, overly colored, but that's fine. On the next one, let's push the saturation up to about the same. This is quite an easy grade because we had good footage to start with. But if you start with some worse footage, like these two clips, I probably wouldn't use. I wouldn't actually be using these in my edit, but we're going to use them to see how we can fix this very green, very blue footage, which is very common for new videographers that haven't got the filters, they haven't got their color balance right. So we can just use exactly what we just did. We can start with the offset. Look down here, the reds are minimal. The reds have gone off the chart. The greens and the blues are here. So yet again, we can just bring the reds up. Let's bring the reds so that they're just touching up here. We bring the greens down until some of the darks start touching here. And then we can bring the blues down. So that's kind of matching the green. We can then see that the highs up here are all a bit low, so we could push all the gain up by using the gain bar to brighten the whole scene a little bit. But you see there's still a lot of greens and blues in the mid-range, so we can try and adjust just the mid-range green and blues by using the gamma and turning down the green and the blue here. So we bring the greens down a little bit, bring the blues down a little bit. Which, yeah, whenever you do this, it's suddenly going to bring the darks up a bit, so we can crush this down a little bit more, push the blacks down a little bit more, see if we can, it's starting to look a bit too green now, so let's turn the green down a bit more, till the background's going a little bit bluer, I think about there. I think this is about as good as we can get. Yet again, if you do Control D, you see we've gone from this to that, which is a lot more acceptable, even though it's not exactly perfect. And just playing around with these bars and checking your scopes, you can make a huge difference. We can then right click, grab a still. We can go to our next clip, dragging along here. Right click on our still, click on apply grade, and there we go. Anyway, see, we've gone from a very green photo, green video, and we brought those reds up, and it's looking a lot more colourful. I'll now quickly do the rest of the clips. And there you have it, our primary grading done. Thank you for watching and hope you stay tuned for our next one.